Hey everybody, it's Glider Cat, and it's time to play. We're back in Voxel Tycoon. Let me unpause the game and let me show you what I learned. I did a little bit, or what I think I may have learned, did a little bit of investigation as to why we can't seem to buy diesel vehicles, right? It says not suitable for this depot. In fact, if I click on diesel, all of them that we can currently have access to are not available. Looks like, oh, we just got a message that a man of colonies doesn't accept wood planks anymore. So we just were a little too late. Yeah, we were just a little too late, I think. Or did we send them to Summersville? Sorry to get distracted. Let's just check this real quick. I think that was, we were doing wood planks down here, weren't we? To man of colonies west. Yeah, planks to a man of colonies west. All right, let's take this truck and send it back to the depot. Or send it to a garage, and I'll get back to my discussion here. So any of these is fine. We can put it in the new one. Yeah, so we haven't been able to buy the diesel vehicles. I looked at the research tree, and we got to pick a new one anyway. I was kind of looking through here trying to figure out, is there something that would, you know, allow us to purchase these vehicles? There's nothing descriptive here in this text that tells us what we need, but I'm guessing here under roads 2, this research gets us a garage level 2. Now, it's just a guess on my part. There's no, I can't right click or get any context off of this, but it could be that we need this garage level 2 in order to house the diesel vehicles. So I'm going to work under that assumption. I asked the question in the Discord, just waiting to hear back. If that's the case or not. I tried checking the wiki, but again, this is an early access game, pretty early as far as solidifying all the features in that. So I could not find any information on how to purchase the diesel trucks. Now, in order for us to research roads too, we need stone. So if we really wanted to go after that, we would need to get stone. And I think we saw stone in one of these other areas. I'm looking off to the side here. Iron ore. I thought we had one that was bordering us that did offer stone. Okay, that one's got wood. That one's got sand. Thought we saw stone over here. This guy has copper. This one has coal. We have plenty of that. This has a town with copper ore as a resource, but I thought we had one that had stone. There it is. Stone, 292,000. That'll get us stone. That's not that far away. If we look, we're about 100 grand away from that. We may just save up and buy this and then set up a production chain or whatever, set up some routes to deliver stone to our lab, or maybe even build another lab over here. Let's take a look at that research again and see what else is required that may be worth doing. Roads 2, it just takes stone and cash. And how much do the labs cost us? Let's take a look at that. Industry, labs. Labs aren't cheap. So we may just route that stone down to our existing lab and take the hit initially in transit costs. All right. So let's keep that in mind. We'll save up some cash and then maybe we'll go do that. They'll give us another town to supply resources to too. In the meantime, we've got, we're not going to prevent this business from closing. We can try. Let's pause. We've got planks here. It's this business is about to close down. We have a, looks like we do have a freight station here. Where is it? Summersville North. Oh no, that's a bus station. So we do not currently have a freight station in range of this factory that wants wood planks. Click logistics. We can see that one does not reach. So there's a hardware store that needs planks. We got 14 days to pull it off. We've got a truck that can go do it. but we would have to build a freight station. Anybody else need planks? Let's see if Newport. No, I thought I saw a new business spring up. Of course, this one needs the one we're not making. This guy wants wood beams. Now we could switch over production. Maybe that's a better choice, right? So this guy, this hardware store that requires wood beams, we might be able to swing something with that. We can change our production line over here from planks to wood beams, or set up another one, maybe. Another warehouse here, right next to this guy, and run another line of this wood through a circular saw and make the beams. Again, we may have to scale this up differently. Let's do that. That's going to result in more income for us long term. So let's do that. Let's do it now. Let's go ahead and place our saw. So we'll go into factories. Circular saw. We can place that one right next to this guy. Boom. Then conveyors. Pop this guy down. That's going to get us our logs. Hook that up. Boom. Change the direction the way we want it. Boom. And then pipe this into another warehouse. Let's see. Hopefully, if we pop down a warehouse, it will be in range of that. Yeah, we're good. It's going to cost us some cash here because the ground's not level. But I say we put it down right smack dab next to this guy. Or we could leave a little path so we could run a belt in between for when we want to do more warehouses. Why don't we do that? That's a little bit of planning ahead. In fact, I'm going to leave a little bit of space. Ooh. Wow, this reaches pretty far. That's the furthest we can go. Let's do that just for the heck of it. And then let's see if we can get a belt routed up this hill. See what that's all about. I'm doing it because I'm thinking we could put another warehouse in here later. And I just wanted to know what the furthest distance was from that freight station. So it's going to cost a little more to set it up this way. But again, I'm kind of, you know, experimenting with the systems in the game to figure out what we can and can't do. So that came up the hill pretty darn nice. Let's stop it right there for now. Get our loader. Let's see what they call it again. The connector. Can we come in from the side? Let's just see if this works. Again, we're going to learn as we go. Let's grab more belt and see. Yep. That looks all great. Whoops. I need to left click and then left click again. That looks like it's routed correctly. Let's set this guy to wood beams. Boom. Let's set our saw to wood beams. Boom. So now we got planks and wood beams. And then let's set up, we need to set up another route. So let's see. Here is planks to a mana. This truck doesn't have anything on it. Ooh. Wait a second here. Nice. So I think we just cancel. Okay. Are you sure you want to stop configuring the vehicle? Yes. Here is our existing truck that I believe we sent back to the garage. If I'm not mistaken, right? We assigned it a route and then we decided we don't need it. Doesn't have any planks on them. It doesn't appear, right? This is the car here, 47. He's configured for wood planks. But it looks like when it's in the garage, I've got the option to reconfigure. So that's how we do it. So we just learned something there. I can click on the little reconfigure button and then change his configuration. So we'll set him to wood beams. Apply that. Nice. Now we're going to create a route to get these wood beams. Matter of fact, I'll hit play just so we can see them being produced. We should start seeing some logs coming out here. Here's our planks. We got a warehouse full of planks. Should see beams coming out here. And as soon as we do, I'm going to pause it again. Okay, nice, nice. Because I want to get this truck on route. Because it may take him a while to even get here. So let's change his schedule to individual route. And we'll add a stop here. I guess I can just pick up. So it's going to load. And I think for this route, I think it might be a good idea to just have that refit step go to wood beams. I don't know. It seems like that may be good practice. Let's do it, and then we'll see if it has negative consequence down the road. Where do we want to deliver the wood beams? Way over into Newport Beach, I believe. So let's find our way over there. And I got to drop down a station. That one's not going to do it. That's a bus station anyway. Let's pop down a freight station. So roads, stations, freight station. It's already selected. How about we come down this road here? I guess we should look at what kind of coverage we have. We could come on this side. Let's do that. We'll just see how it goes. Or we could do something clever like pop it in here. That's still in range. Let's try this just for fun and give ourselves a little bit of road here to work with. Where they can kind of come down and do that U-turn. And let's set the future growth here to still have a road coming off that way. We'll give it a shot. Again, we're just kind of experimenting. That's going to be our stop. Let's go ahead and go back to the truck that's delivering the wood beams. We'll add a stop. Newport branch. Unload. Newport Beach branch, I should say. We'll save this with a name. Wood beams. That's fine. It's Newport Beach. Okay. I like that. And then let's buy another one of these trucks. Again, we can't do the diesel yet, so that was kind of a waste researching the diesel engine because we can't seem to purchase them yet. So we'll grab another wood truck. Let's see, we've got two to choose from. This one's faster and carries more, so let's buy that guy. Buy it, and then we'll assign this one. It's bigger, so I didn't want to do the copy routine because I want the newer truck. This one we already had in inventory, so we're just making use of it. This guy, I just need to assign the route. It's going to be the wood beams one. There it is, wood beam to Newport Beach. And let's set these two trucks loose. One, two. One is faster than the other and carries more. And let's hit play. And then we can see those guys should be on their way. From my garages down here. Where are the garages? Here they go. So hopefully we'll get some wood beams. Now that guy looks like he is set to auto, doesn't he? If I pause here, I'll show you what I mean. See how he's got that little magic wand? So we didn't actually configure him for wood beams. But as soon as he hits that station, where he's going to pick up the wood beams, he'll be refitted to wood beams before he tries to load products. So we should be safe, and that just kind of illustrates why it might be a good practice to have that refit step as the first stop when you're picking up resources. Your first step. Cool. Let's let that guy go, and let's take a look at this route, the coal to Summersville route. I'm going to go into all the routes here. We just want to see if these guys have unloaded all their iron, because I kind of screwed that up earlier. Sort the route list. Let's look for coal to Summersville. There it is, coal to Summersville. They've all got coal on them, so I can get rid of this last route here to unload iron, basically, is what this was for. So let's edit the route, and let's take out this last stop. Boom. Hit OK, and now we recovered from that mistake. Good, 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 good. All right. We do need to pick research. Now, I spent a bunch of cash just buying those trucks and getting the wood beam production going. So it's going to be a little bit before we can get the stone. Let's see if there's a research we can do in between while we're raising cash. Ideally, one that takes... ideally, some research that takes up the iron or other products that we've got. Even the wood beams would be fine. Okay, these are the different things we've researched. That's the history. All right. Just wondering why I have to come into this first before I get to this screen. I'm kind of expecting this pop-up to come up first when I hit the research little beaker, but... All right, let's select new research. Let's see what we got. We've got researching. Now, I'm not sure what these things do. I would love to be able to get some context when I mouse over this or right click or something. Diesel engine 2. We don't want to bother with that. That's for sure. Storages. I think we're fine. Steel smelting sounds interesting. We have the iron smelting. We can't make steel bars yet. No one's asking for them. Steam engines is going to help us on the trains. It takes coal. We've got coal. We could actually do trains now. Roads too. Again, we're waiting on the stone. Rails, stone, mining. Mining. That's going to allow us to do the copper mine. This might make sense right here. So mining's a good candidate. Manufacturing too. It's going to open up a bunch of stuff for us. That might be even better, right? This woodworking might get us the furniture in that. That's my guess. Let's see. Wood frames, furniture. Yeah. I like that better. Manufacturing 2 is the current candidate. We've got iron bars, tons of them. In fact, we have a warehouse probably full of them right now. Heavy diesel engine, that's for the trains. We'll come back to that. We don't have territory with copper yet, so manufacturing seems like the clear winner. And we've already got routes for all of this, so we don't have to do anything but pick it and move on. And we should have a warehouse already full of iron bars. So that lab should be going full time. Very cool. Newport Beach. Hopefully we're going to be able to supply these beams. It's probably going to take more trucks, so we're probably going to have to spend a little more money to meet this demand. Wood beam is awful. Have they gotten any yet? That's a people mover. A couple buses here. Or no, what is this guy doing? Yeah, I guess so. Well, we're picking up passengers, so that's a decent sign. We'll make a little money here. I think these guys will unload. Boom. Yeah, I made a little money. All right. Just was hoping that we'd see some beams come through here. I think we need to add probably 2 more trucks to be able to meet this need. 1 required population. See what that says. Okay, demand can't upgrade to the next level because its satisfaction is less than good. All right. So that's just showing us that, you know, once we get up to the good level, then demand will increase and we'll get one of those notifications saying, hey, demand has increased. Okay, we've seen all these messages. Nothing to see there. We have not brought those beams over yet. We can take a look at where those trucks are by clicking on our freight station and then doing this routine. So here they come and we're running at kind of slow speed. Wow, those are big beams. Look at that truck. All right, cool. Actually, we're saving here. So we got a little bit of lag. Let me go ahead and pick that truck. And then buy another one. We have the cash to do it. We haven't paid down debt at all recently. Oops. This time I can just copy. This is the one I want. Right here. Let's send that guy off on his way. And maybe one more. I don't have the resource to do it, though. Let's go ahead and crank up the speed. Okay, business went... Oh, no. Okay, yeah, we knew that was going to go bankrupt. Kind of skipped that one on purpose because it was so close to going bankrupt. And we opted for the wood beams instead where we had a little more time. Let me go ahead and crank up the speed to 3 times. And let's just do the rounds. Okay, we've got sand here. Now, we don't have sand anywhere. There's our wood beams just got delivered. So we're in good shape there. Sand we don't have yet. I think I want stone next. So I think this is going to be the next region we buy. It's going to get us a town, the town of Orem, who needs coal and wood beams, which we're already producing. So we'll be off to a good start here once we connect this town up. It's going to cost some cash to buy it, right? 3 million. Wait a second. 3 million. I thought this one was way less. What am I thinking here? Unlock. Oh, I must have been looking at something different. You know what I was looking at? I was looking at the supply of stone. And I was thinking, hey, we only need $292,000 to buy this region. I was a little bit off because we actually need $3 million to buy that. So that's going to take a while. Shoot. So we got to get to making some cash here. We cannot buy any regions for a long time. It looks like, yeah, they're all in the $3 million range. So we got to amp up our profits here in a big way. Let's see what we can do. Let's go through the towns again and see what we can do. Population's good. Average economy and average passenger satisfaction. Okay, Amana Colonies now accepts wood planks. Let's slow down and get that going. So we have another factory that wants the wood planks sprung up. We had a couple go out of business. But we've got the planks. Let's just see if that's within a freight station. Probably not. Ooh, I wonder if I click on this guy and do logistics. Oh, nice. So I clicked on the factory and clicked on logistics, and I can see pretty quickly there's no freight stations within range. This one's close, but it's just not there. We've got some kind of icky terrain here, but maybe we flatten this out and put a freight station up here, and then we can satisfy that need for planks pretty easy. Let's do it. Let's spend a little on terraforming. I'll just do level, and hopefully this isn't going to break the bank. Boom. And then maybe we put a freight station up here somewhere. In fact, we could. We're on a hill. Let's just see how it develops. We'll grab a freight station. I mean, we could go kind of over like this and still be in range. What are we doing with our other freight stations? One, that's a bus station here. We have a freight station there that probably has pretty decent range. Maybe I can come up this way a little. Let's try that. Connect up our roads. And we should be able to satisfy this need fairly easily. Road didn't cost too much. So we're going to need trucks, though. Let me double the speed here. Go to 2x speed just so we have money for trucks. We're going to need to set up a route for this. Let's go ahead and buy another one of these bigger ones, the L10. 10 kilometers an hour faster, more powerful. I don't know. It doesn't show the maintenance cost here. There's probably some trade-offs associated with this. Ooh, yeah, and it does the planks. Yeah, we're good there. All right, not enough money. We got to wait. We're real close. So we'll just wait a second here. Uh-oh, the numbers are going in the wrong direction. We should be making money. We've got a lot of trucks on the road. They're not all like losing money. So there we go. All right. Let's see this. Yeah, we can't do furniture yet. We don't have it unlocked. So that message has popped up. We just have to live with it. There's nothing we can do. Let's go ahead and select this truck and get a new route going. Add a stop. We're going to pick up planks. And actually, before we even do that, I'm going to escape. I'm going to configure this guy right off the bat to do planks. We're going to set that in the route too. I'm just going to be double careful. Cancel. Apply. Okay, now let's add that route. Go pick up the planks. We're going to get them from this station here. Boom. We got a warehouse full of them. Load. And I'm going to do the old routine here of the refit. Because I know this is going to be planks and planks only on this route. So let's just make sure there's no accidents. Hauling the wrong product. Okay, we are going to deliver planks. Where was that? Way up here, was it? Where was that? Down here. Here we go. In a man of colonies. We'll select that guy, unload. That's all good. We'll save it with a good name. Wood plank to a mana. That looks clear to me. Then let's clone this truck. Don't have the money. Let's send this guy on his way. We'll leave this open and then clone it in a second here. Once we get the cash. We need something like close to 60,000, right, for these trucks. It's not cheap. How's our research doing? We're, what, 3/4 of the way, just about? That guy's spinning away. Got plenty of iron bars, another 63 left. We got 2 trucks supplying iron bars. We could almost get by with just one. Now, we probably have some inefficient trucks. We probably have somebody delivering wood still. See how we have a warehouse full of wood? Not sure if we took that truck off that was supplying that wood. I think it was depositing it here. We may look at the our fleet. It should tell us, though. We should get little pop-ups, right? New point of sale, Summersville, now accepts wood beams. Awesome. So we can expand there as well. There's wood beams for Summersville. Right now we're doing the Amana colonies, trying to get that with enough trucks to make sense. And we're waiting on some cash here. Probably like another 4,000 bucks. Let's try it. Boom. Not enough money. We were close. We'll get there. Boom. Let's send that guy away. Wood planks to a mana. Release all. While we're waiting on cash to accrue, let's, I guess, think about supplying the wood beams over here. It'd be nice if we had a freight station nearby, but of course we don't. Nothing in range. We could probably pop one down this way. Again, it all takes money. How are we doing on profit? Let's just see. Do we have a bunch of, like, are we losing money or something? 300 grand trade. We've got 72 and 80, $90,000 in expenses. Our research has been costing us money. That makes sense. We're losing money on research for sure. Loan interest is down, right? We've been paying it off. Not lately, but we have been paying down the down our loan. $475,000. It was up to $950. So it's not as bad as it was. But we're a little cash short. You know, that research is taking a toll. It's pretty significant. Matter of fact, it's more expensive than running our vehicles and maintaining all of our factory buildings and warehouses and freight stations. So yeah, that's worth considering. Usually I like to keep the research going in these games. Just always, you know, as much as possible, keep that going, that tech tree moving. But in this case, it's kind of slowing us down in terms of our ability to make more money. We need some cash on hand. Now, I could borrow more, but I don't like doing that. Because I don't like paying interest. I don't like doing it in real life. I don't like doing it in the game. But it might make sense to take a loan for expansion because it will drive profit. We'll see if we can get by without it. Amana East, or Amana Colonies, I think is doing good with the planks. We want to try and get beams over here. The first step's going to be that freight station. Let's at least get it selected. Not roads. Okay, freight station. Ooh, we can do. Oh no, I'm not sure what waypoint is. Let's see. What makes sense? How about here for beams? Boom. And now let's go see if we can get a truck for beams. This is the guy we've been using. We can buy it. Let's get it configured to do the beams right out of the gate. Again, abundance of caution. And get a route going. You're going to pick up beams from down here. Hopefully we have a good amount of production. Looks like we've got a lot in storage. So we should be okay. We need to beef up these routes with more trucks. Okay, we'll pick up from there. And this one is... before I select this second station, again, I'm going to make sure I do the refit. Again, you may not need to do this if you're careful, but I've made enough mistakes so far that I think this is giving me a little bit of extra protection against having the wrong products brought to a freight station that will not accept them and then having an unprofitable route. Okay, now we can add that stop, unload. Load, unload. That all looks good. Let's save it with a good name. Wood beams to Summersville. That's pretty descriptive. Let's send that truck on its way so it can start making us some cash. And then let's immediately clone it because we've got the money to do it. And we'll just set this guy loose too. Not bad. All right, we had some businesses go bankrupt, but we've had new ones sprout up. And we've managed to satisfy, I think, three this episode, right? We did planks in Amana Colonies. We've got beams going in Summersville, and I think beams going down here in Newport. Is that right? Yeah, and beams in Newport. So at the top of the next episode, let's take a look at... Oh, the other thing we learned this episode, I should say, is that in order to buy territory, it's going to cost a ton of money. I can't even remember where that stone was. I thought it was over this way, the one that had the stone. For some reason, I can't seem to scroll over there. And now it's letting me. I see. Yeah, I was thinking it was 292,000 cash to open up this territory. It's not. It's 3 million. So close, but not quite. So it'll be a while before we can expand. So yeah, next episode, we'll look at shoring up some more of our shipping routes and seeing if we can't maximize profit and get some of these industries to grow. Now look at all these trucks we've got on the roads. At some point, we're going to need to upgrade. And then at another point down the road, we're going to need to figure out how to make use of trains and where it makes sense to do so. So we'll have to give that some thought too. But for now, this is GliderCat signing off saying thanks so much for watching. If you enjoy this content, please consider giving it a thumbs up. That helps my tiny channel grow, and I would definitely appreciate that. But until next time, I will see you in the next episode.